Hello, my dear friends. I am Dr. Waseem I. Khan, Assistant Professor, Sri Shivaji Law College, Parbhani, Maharashtra, India. So today's point of discussion will be a third very important defense of law of tort, that is an inevitable accident. In what circumstances and in what situation this defense can be taken by the defendant, we will discuss in this particular lecture, along with the essential of defense of this defense, as well as a certain case law we will discuss relating to this particular defense. So let's start the topic. The third defense under a law of tort is inevitable accident. So in this particular lecture, under what circumstances the defendant is able to take the defense of inevitable accident, we will discuss. So what exactly inevitable accident means? Accident means an unexpected occurrence of something that could not have been predicted or prevented. So what accident literally means, the meaning of accident is that any unexpected event which cannot be predicted or which cannot be prevented, that particular event is supposed to be known as an accident. So any act which cannot be predicted, and if predicted cannot be prevented, that is called accident. So in such a case, the defendants will not be liable if they had no intention to cause it and if the plaintiff is injured because of it. Suppose if any unexpected occurrence happens and such particular event cannot be prevented by applying a care and skill, that particular event is supposed to be known as an inevitable accident, and that particular accident, if any person suffers a harm, then defendant will be liable and defendant will be able to take the defense of inevitable accident, because in this particular scenario, defendant is having no intention to cause any kind of harm to the other person. So because that particular event is unexpected and which cannot be prevented by the defendant. Suppose if any event is that which can be prevented by the defendant, then defendant will not be able to take the defense of inevitable accident. If any event is that which can be prevented by the defendant by applying a care, then that particular case will not come under the category of inevitable accident. So if the defendant is having no intention to cause any kind of harm to the plaintiff, but the plaintiff suffered a harm due to the event which cannot be prevented by the defendant, then defendant will be able to take the defense of inevitable accident. So there is one case which explains the defense of inevitable accident, and that case is Harnam Singh versus RP Auto Aid. So in this particular case, the defendant was the accident happens due to the bursting of tire, and in that particular accident the plaintiff sustained a loss, and by virtue of that particular loss plaintiff filed a suit against the defendant. But in this case, the defendant took the defense of inevitable accident. But the scenario of this particular case is that the defendant in this particular case was using a worn out tire, and the reason of accident was bursting of tire due to excessive speed. So what are the reason of accident? The reason of accident is excessive speed, and due to the excessive speed the tire burst, and the defendant was using a worn out tire. The tire was not in a good condition. So the accident took place, plaintiff sustained a loss, plaintiff filed a suit against the defendant, and defendant took the defense of inevitable accident. It is my question whether a defendant can take a defense of inevitable accident in this particular case. The answer is no. Why? Because in this particular case, the accident can be prevented by replacing a worn out tire by new one. So defendant was using a tire which was not in a good condition. So defendant can replace that particular tire with the new one and the accident could be prevented. This is the one case. Another case is that the defendant knows very well about the condition of tire. So he could drive the vehicle in a moderate speed so as he could prevent the accident, but the accident took place due to the excessive speed, and due to the excessive speed the tire burst out. So in this particular case the court held that the defendant is liable for the injury which is caused to the plaintiff, and the defendant is not able to take the defense of inevitable accident, because in this case the accident could be prevented by taking a due care. That's why defense of inevitable accident was not available. Padmavati versus Dugganayika. In this particular case, the accident took place due to the dislodging of wheel from axle. So the reason of accident in this particular case, the wheel has been dislodged from the axle, and due to the dislodging of wheel, the accident took place in which the plaintiff sustained a loss, and plaintiff filed a suit against the defendant, and in this case also the defendant took the defense of inevitable accident. But the court decided a case in favor of the defendant. Court says that yes, defense of inevitable accident is available for the defendant because the dislodging of wheel from axle cannot be predicted and cannot be prevented by a defendant by taking a due care. So that's why defense of inevitable accident was available with the defendant in this particular case. Holmes versus Mather. So in this case, a defendant was driving a horse on a public road, and due to the barking of dog, the horse started running, and the defendant servant tried utmost to control the speed of horse, but he could not control the horse, and the horse dashed the plaintiff who was standing in his balcony, and the plaintiff sustained a loss. Plaintiff sustained an injury. Plaintiff filed a suit against the defendant. But in this case also the defendant took the defense of inevitable accident. Now my questions to you, that whether the defendant can take the defense of inevitable accident in this particular case. The court says yes. Why? Because when the horse started running, the servant of the defendant tried his all level best to control the speed of the horse, but he could not. He has taken all care to avoid the accident, but he could not prevent the accident, and it is the case of inevitable accident, court says, and the court held not liable to the defendant, and court says that the defense of inevitable accident is available with the defendant. So these are the particular cases which dealt with the defense of inevitable accident. I hope you understand this topic. If you understand this topic, please subscribe my channel, hit the notification button, hit the like button, and share this video with your friends. Thank you. Thank you very much.